Hello, this is Mike Sayers from Mechanical Simulation. In this video instructional, I'll be showing how to use the graphic user interface in CarSim to make a new vehicle and simulate it. I should mention that the same approach is used in TruckSim and BikeSim, except with truck and motorcycle models. On the run control screen, the dataset is locked. We will keep it locked. I will use the duplicate button to make a new run that will involve the new vehicle. Now, this is a link to an existing vehicle data set. These blue links are configurable hyperlinks. The drop-down control above lists all the libraries that might be appropriate to use here. In this case, we're using the library named Vehicle Assembly. The little button below is a drop-down that gives all the data sets that are in this library. We're currently using the data set called C-Class Hatchback. We'll make a copy of that and link to it. And the way to do that is with the second item here that says copy and link data set. I'll take the default name for now. This shows the new name. I can visit the data set by clicking on it because it is a hyperlink. Now we have the rigid sprung mass link up here, a bunch of other properties. For now, we'll just look at the sprung mass. The same thing, we have several libraries that we could link to. And the one that we are linked, we have just the one C-Class Hatchback data set. We will copy that and link to it. So now I have a new vehicle assembly and I have a new sprung mass data set. They're just copies of what we had already. So now we'll make some changes. I'll click to go to the sprung mass data set. And this has properties of the sprung mass and locations of points in it. This screen is something we looked at also in the vehicle coordinate systems instructional video, talking about the significance of the axes and how they're used to define other points. One of the points that we changed in that video, we'll change here also, is the height of the rear wheel when it's in static equilibrium. It's at 325 millimeters above the x-axis. I'll make that number smaller, 200. On both sides. That has the effect of pushing down the wheel relative to everything else. Since the ground's not going to move, the effect is to raise the sprung mass. I click back and go here, and I'm reminded that I have the default name of hatchback number one. Maybe it would be better if I named it to indicate that it's raised in the rear. So I can do that by going to the edit menu and choosing the option to change a title. You can also use Control T and give it a new name. Now I might want to come back and look at the screen again. So I'll pin this tab up here. Right click, choose Pin This Tab, and it will persist when we leave the screen. I go back to the vehicle screen. I see the new name here. I go back to the Run Control screen. To make a run, I just click the Run Math Model button. We'll look at a video by clicking the video button. And I can see that the rear is raised a little bit. Now, how does the response compare with what we had before? As we've seen in the other videos, we can overlay results. I'll go to the original quick start guide baseline. I will make this one a different color, say yellow. And use video plus plot. Now we can clearly see the difference between the vehicle equilibrium positions here. The yellow one is raised relative to the blue one. Let's look at the plots and see what's different here. The steering is about the same. Steering of the wheels is about the same. Lateral slip is about the same. But now we're at the roll angle and we're seeing that the yellow one, the baseline pound two, is rolling a little bit more than the default one. Looking at the max values, we see that the modified one is 3.379. The original is 3.06 degrees in roll. We'll do one more variation here. We'll use the tab to go back to the sprung mass screen and make another change. This time we'll change the front, make those 100, 100. So we're pushing those down even further than we push the rear ones down, which should have the effect of raising the front. We'll go back to home, run this one again, And I have the animator still open. A nice feature is that if we are redoing the same run multiple times like this, we can click the, or we can select the option to reload the data. And now we see the new one, which is raised a little in the back and a lot in the front. And we're seeing even more roll with the new one, as we would expect because we've raised the CG. In this video, we've seen how blue links work and are configured, how to copy link to make new datasets, such as the new vehicle and sprung mass, how to pin a tab to jump back to a screen of interest, as we did for the sprung mass screen, how to overlay results and analyze the plots, and reload outputs in VS Visualizer to see new results very quickly with the reload menu option. I'll remind you again to see the other video, Vehicle Coordinate Systems, for more information about the sprung mass and the coordinate system. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching.